Hello and welcome to another session of Let's Learn German. I hope you revised the contents of the previous session and you are ready to learn something new and interesting in this session. In this session, we are going to do a special category of verbs which are called separable verbs in English, and in German they are called trennbare Verben. As you can see, here I have written separable verbs, so these are the special category of verbs in German which can be separated. You are already familiar with the term verbs. Verbs are something which denote an action, and you are already familiar with verbs in German which are like kommen, singen, hören, tanzen, etc., etc. Now let us look how trennbare Verben are used in the language. Now let us look at this construction. We have here the word mit, and you are already familiar with this word which is a verb called kommen. And I already told you in the previous session, in German language verbs exist in infinitive form and they are conjugated with the respective subjects or nominative. So here we have a verb which is attached to a prefix which I have written here. So as you can see, a separable verb or a trennbare Verb consists of a prefix and an infinitive verb. If you know, a prefix means something which is fixed at the beginning. So here we have this word mit, which is fixed to the verb kommen, which means mitkommen, which in English means to come along. Now let us look at this verb anrufen. Here again it is consisting of a prefix and an infinitive verb, where the prefix is an and the infinitive verb is rufen. The verb here in totality is called anrufen, which means to make a telephone call. Now let us look at this verb zurückkommen. Now again this verb contains a prefix which is zurück and an infinitive verb kommen. So we have the verb zurückkommen, which means to come back. I would like to tell you that by the addition of prefix to any verb, the change in meaning also takes place. So kommen without the prefix, which would mean to come, here it would mean to come along. However, here the verb zurückkommen would mean to come back. So whenever you are learning any trennbare Verb or the separable verb, make sure that you learn the verb in its complete meaning along with the prefix, because without the prefix the verb might have a completely different meaning. Now let us see how these separable verbs are used in sentences. Here we have a sentence ich komme mit. As you can see, here we have three components: the subject, the verb and the suffix. Now what do you mean by suffix? Suffix here is what earlier was prefix. So prefix is something which is at the beginning, and suffix is a part of the verb which is now at the end. So as you know, in the sentence we always place the verb at the second position. So here we have the verb kommen, which is conjugated according to the subject ich, and it is called ich komme mit. Now let us look at this sentence ruft mich an. Now in this sentence, as you can see, the verb is at the second position, the prefix an moves to the end and becomes a suffix, and the verb is conjugated according to the subject which is third person masculine singular pronoun, and here we have the accusative pronoun form of ich, which is mich, so which means he calls me. Now let us look at this sentence sie kommt heute zurück. Here also the infinite separable verb zurückkommen has been conjugated, where the prefix zurück has moved towards the end and becomes the suffix suryuk. The verb common is conjugated according to the third person feminine pronoun sie. And here there is a new word heute, which means today. So, the meaning of this sentence would be she comes back today. So, as you can see here, the verb is at the second position, which is the rule as you know in the sentence. The verb is always conjugated according to the noun or to the pronoun, which is always attached to the noun, and then follows the rest of the elements in the sentence. So, in this sentence ish comma mit, there is only one subject, whereas in second sentence er ruft mich an, there are two nouns, one the subject and the other is the object. And whereas in this sentence sie kommt heute zurück, we have only one subject or noun, which is sie. Now, in this segment, we are going to do the categories of regular verbs and irregular verbs for the separable verbs or trennbare Verben. You are already familiar with the concept of regular verbs and irregular verbs, which we did in the previous session. The same theory applies here. However, there are slight changes which you are supposed to be noting here. Now, let us look at the regular verbs here. You know that for regular verbs, there isn't any change in the verb apart from the ending of the verb. So, here we have the verb mit singen, which means to sing along. So, we have the sentence here, ich singe das Lied mit. As you can see here, we took the verb and conjugated it according to the pronoun ich, and the prefix has been moved to the end and which through which it becomes the suffix. Now, in this sentence, we have the verb einkaufen, which means to shop or to buy. Now, let us see how this verb has been conjugated here. Wir kaufen im Supermarkt ein. Now, here the part of the verb which is kaufen is used to conjugate it with the pronoun wir, and the prefix ein goes towards the end and becomes a suffix. Now, let us look at this verb ausgehen. You are already familiar with the verb gehen, which means to go. However, the verb ausgehen means to go out in terms of, you know, to go out and enjoy. So, we have here the conjugation of the verb gehen with the pronoun du, which is gehst, du heute aus. If you see, this is a question where the verb is at the first position. If you know that the verb at this first position means that this is a yes or no question, so it will generate a yes or no answer. So, we have this sentence here, gehst du heute aus, which means are you going out today? Now, let us look at this verb einsteigen. Einsteigen means to get inside a vehicle. Here, if you look at the sentence, bitte steigen Sie in den Bus ein. Here we have the verb steigen conjugated according to the second person formal pronoun Sie, and the prefix ein has been moved towards the end, which makes it to the suffix. As I told you, verbs when they don't exist without any prefix, they might have a different meaning. But along with the prefix, they assume a new meaning, and that is valid for all the separable verbs. Now, let us look at the irregular verbs under the category of separable verbs or trennbare Verben. Here we have the verb einladen. Here the verb einladen means to invite. You know that irregular verbs are the verbs in which there is a change not only at the end of the sentence. If you look in the category of irregular verbs, we have this verb called einladen, which means to invite. You know that irregular verbs not only change the ending here at towards the verb conjugation end, but also there is a change happening in the middle of the verb. So, the verb einladen where the part of the verb laden, here as you can see we have an a umlaut which is missing in the infinitive verb. So we have the sentence, sie lädt uns zur Party ein. So if you follow the conjugation of the irregular verbs, especially in the category of separable verbs, you have to follow the same rule as you did in the previous session for irregular verbs without the prefix. Now let us look at this sentence, anfangen. This verb means to begin. Now let us see how this verb functions. Wann fängt die Konferenz an? So here we have the conjugation of the verb fangen from infinitive to fängt along with the noun die Konferenz, and the prefix an goes towards the end and becomes a suffix. If you see this construction, here we have a question which begins with a W, and if you remember, all the W questions have verb at the second position conjugated according to the subject or the nominative. Now let us look at this verb mitfahren, which means to travel along with somebody or to drive along with somebody. If you look at this sentence, fährst du zur Universität mit? Are you also traveling to the university, or are you also driving to the university? Here as you can see, the verb fahren has been conjugated to fährst because of the pronoun du, and you are familiar with this construction, and the prefix mit has been pushed to the end which becomes its suffix. And if you see, the verb is at the first position which makes it into a yes or no question. Now let us look at this verb mitnehmen. You are already familiar with the verb nehmen, which means to take. However, mitnehmen means to take along something, and here we have an example which is a question. As you can see, nimmt sie den Laptop mit? Does she take the laptop along with her? Here as you can see, the verb nehmen has been conjugated according to the third person feminine pronoun sie. The verb is at the first position, which as you know shows that this is a question which requires a yes or no answer, and the prefix mit has been pushed towards the end making it into a suffix. So did you find separable verbs and their category like irregular verbs and regular verbs difficult? Well, they are not difficult if you learn the conjugation of the verb and the rules which are applied to the conjugation of the verbs for irregular and regular separable verbs. Now in this segment we will do certain examples and we can learn some more aspects about separable verbs in a better manner. Now we are going to do an example where we look at few separable verbs and see how separable verbs are used in a sentence along with the conjugation with the pronouns or the nouns. Here as you can see, the verb in the bracket is abfahren, which means to depart. Now as you know, here the verb is in the infinitive form and we are supposed to conjugate the verb, and if you see the sentence, there are two blanks here. So as you know, two blanks means one blank is for the verb and one blank is for the prefix which becomes a suffix. And as you can see, since it is a question, we would write the verb at the first position and we will conjugate the verb along with the noun der Zug, which means the train. Now let us write the answer. Fährt der Zug bald? Ab. As you know, the verb fahren when conjugated with the noun in third person changes its form because it is an irregular verb. So abfahren is an irregular separable verb. Now let us look at the sentence number 2. Der Vater, das Baby, and in bracket we have the verb anziehen, which means to dress, and As you can see, it consists of the verb cn and the prefix an. So, let us conjugate this verb where the conjugation happens along with the noun der Vater. So, we have der Vater zieht das Baby an. Now, let us look at sentence number 3. Bitte blank Sie Ihr Büro. In bracket, we have the verb aufräumen, and here auf is the prefix and räumen is the verb. So, we will conjugate the verb part according to the pronoun here, and as you know, the ending of the verb with Z is always en. So, we will write bitte räumen Sie Ihr Büro auf. The verb aufräumen, I would like to tell you, means to clean. Now, let us look at sentence number 4. Here, we have two blanks, one for the verb and one for the prefix. And here, we have the verb in the bracket anrufen, which you know means to make a telephone call. And now, let us conjugate the verb according to the pronoun, which is ihr, which is wann ruft ihr uns an. Now, let us look at sentence number 5. Du die Wäsche. Wäsche means washed clothes or laundry. Bitte. And we have the verbs here in the bracket, which is aufhängen, which means to hang. Now, let us conjugate the verb by conjugating it according to the pronoun. Hängst du die Wäsche auf? Could you please put up the clothes for drying? So, as you can see, we successfully conjugated the verb according to the noun or according to the pronoun. Also, I would like to tell you, as you can see here, certain verbs like sentence number 1 or sentence number 3, 4, 5, 2, all of them are conjugated according to the noun or to the pronoun, of course, as you can see, but also sentence number 1 is a verb which only takes a singular noun, whereas verbs like anziehen, aufräumen, anrufen, aufhängen take a subject as well as an object. So, while using the separable verbs, one should be very careful in also deciding whether the verbs take only one noun or the verb takes nominative, accusative also. Now, let us do an exercise where the student would write the answers and then we will see if the answers given by the student are right or wrong. Now, let us look at the answers given by the student and see if the answers are right or wrong. Here, the student had to write the correct conjugation of the separable verb and also write the place of the prefix and make it into a suffix. Now, let us look at the answers for sentence number 1. Wann fängt der Film an? Here, the verb was anfangen, which means to begin, and the student correctly conjugated the verb fangen as fängt, which is an irregular verb according to the noun der Film, and wrote the prefix as a suffix here at the end. Now, let us look at this sentence. Holt ihr die Kinder vom Kindergarten ab? Here, the verb is abholen, which means to pick up. So, the student wrote the correct conjugation of the verb holen as holt based on the pronoun ihr, and the prefix ab became the suffix ab here. And if you see here, the word meaning of kindergarten, which is familiar to all of us, is kindergarten, where small children are sent. Number 3, wer bereitet das Frühstück vor? Here the verb is vorbereiten, which means to prepare or to cook. So, the student correctly conjugated the verb bereiten as bereitet based on the pronoun here, which is wer, which is a question pronoun, which means who. And here we have another noun, Frühstück, which means breakfast. So, here if we look at this sentence, wer bereitet das Frühstück vor? Here, wer is nominative, das Frühstück is accusative. And we have the prefix vor, which becomes a suffix here. Now, in sentence number 4, wann räumst du die Wohnung auf? Here, the verb is aufräumen, which you know means to clean. And here, the student again correctly conjugated the verb räumen as räumst according to the pronoun du. And here, auf, the prefix becomes the suffix auf. Here also, this verb aufräumen contains subject du and the object die Wohnung, which is accusative. Now, in this sentence, meine Mutter ruft mich jeden Tag an. The verb is anrufen, which means to make a telephone call. And here also, as you can see, the student correctly identified that meine Mutter here is a subject and conjugated the verb rufen as ruft according to that. And the prefix an becomes the suffix an here. Also, as you know, that mich is the accusative pronoun form of the pronoun ich. So, as you can understand, anrufen is a verb which takes not only a nominative but also an accusative. Now, in this last sentence, sie steht immer spät auf. Here we have the verb aufstehen, which means to get up from bed. Now, here, as you see, the verb has been conjugated according to the pronoun sie, which is third person singular feminine pronoun, and the prefix auf becomes suffix auf. Also, as you can see here, there are no other nouns apart from the subject. So, this verb aufstehen usually takes a single noun along with it. And here, if you see, there are two new words for you, immer spät, which means always late. So, as you can see, our student could successfully write the answers for this exercise. Now, let us do another short exercise involving separable verbs. Now, let us do another exercise with separable verbs. In this exercise, we have a separable verb and some other elements which involves nouns or pronouns, and the student would write the correct sentence in this, where the student is supposed to conjugate the separable verb and write the correct form of the verb along with the correct pronoun and make a complete sentence. Now, let us look at the answers given by the student. Here, as you can see, we have three elements, bald, abfahren, mein Bus. And the student has given the correct answer by making the correct sentence, mein Bus fährt bald ab. So, the student correctly conjugated the verb fahren as fährt, and the prefix goes to the end and becomes a suffix. Now, let us look at sentence number 2. Here again, there are four elements, mitarbeiten er nicht gern. Student correctly wrote the conjugation of the verb er arbeitet nicht gern mit, where the prefix mit goes to the end and becomes the suffix mit. Here, the verb mitarbeiten means to work along or to work with. Gern means to like. Now, in this sentence, du einkaufen heute ein. So, here we have elements which the student correctly figured out and wrote kaufst du heute ein. As you know, here we have the verb at the first position, which shows that this is a yes or no question. And as you can see, this question contained two prefixes out of which the student chose the prefix ein here by leaving the ein here, which is also was a cue that presence of two prefixes can actually be similar for one verb. So, in today's session, we did separable verbs or trennbare Verben. We learnt that separable verbs have a prefix and a verb, and the prefix goes towards the end when it is used in a sentence and the verb is conjugated according to the noun or to the pronoun, and based on the sentence type, it is either placed at the first position in a yes or no question or in a second position in a sentence or in a W question. We also learnt that trennbare Verben have got again two categories, regular verbs and irregular verbs, and their conjugation changes. We also did some exercises where you learnt how to use the separable verbs. I hope you would revise what we did in today's session and you would be able to learn more about separable verbs when we use them in the subsequent sessions. So, as I always say, auf Wiedersehen, tschüss.